corner shops and businesses were still closed today as owners tried to assess the damage caused by Saturday's looters. Glaziers have been working round the clock to repair shop fronts, but some fear it will be weeks before business can return to normal. There's also the question of who will pay. Insurance companies are flooded with claims. This shop owner estimates the damage to his business is around £40,000.
There was looting taking place. There was three or four patrol cars outside the shop with police in it, but they were too scared to come out. We tried to stop what we could, but after a while we just gave up. I mean, all right, we'll come back together in a couple of weeks, but it's not going to be the same for another year or so.
People on their way to work this morning who saw the damage for the first time said they were appalled.
I was horrified at the extent of the willful damage that has been caused, which in a way doesn't seem to be a protest at all against the poll tax.
But it's really disgusting. Sickens me.
You know, I was surprised really to see how much damage had been done.
In the Commons this afternoon, the Home Secretary David Waddington spoke of the appalling images which had been sent around the world.
The violence began at Trafalgar Square as hundreds broke away with plans to storm No. 10 Downing Street.
They smashed windows and looted stores, the violence escalating throughout the tourist district.
The violence made front-page news in the Middle East, Italy and France. In America, journalists wrote of London's worst riot in decades. Today, the London Tourist Board said they didn't think tourists would stop visiting the capital, but some people were not so optimistic.
It's a shame for this country. It gives people a very bad impression of Britain. I mean, I'm an ex-tour guide, and I can tell you it gives the tourists coming into this country a very bad impression.
Traders who rely on the tourist industry say they fully expect a drop in profits this summer. Sharon Doughty, Thames News.